The idea for creating the Human Torpedo Unit began in the Second Polish Republic in mid-1939, when the threat from Nazi Germany became real. The unit was very similar to the famous Japanese kamikaze pilots willing to sacrifice their lives to defend their homeland. On May 5, 1939, Adolf Hitler officially demanded the free city of Danzig and the Polish corridor. Polish Minister of Foreign Affairs Josef Beck famously voiced his refusal of German demands in a speech on May 5, 1939.
Pokój jest rzeczą cenną i pożądaną. Nasza generacja, trawiona w wojnach, na pewno na okres pokoju zasługuje. Ale pokój, jak prawie wszystkie sprawy tego świata, ma swoją cenę, wysoką, ale wymierną. My w Polsce nie znamy pojęcia pokoju za wszelką cenę. Jest jedna tylko rzecz w życiu ludzi, narodów i państw, która jest bezcenna. Tą rzeczą jest honor.
A day after his speech, the Polish newspaper published a letter written by a man from Warsaw named Władysław Boczycko, and also signed by his relatives, the brothers Edward and Leon Ludostański. They appeared to the Poles asking them to sacrifice their lives in case of the German attack. The appeal quickly spread all over the country, trumpeted by other newspapers and radio. It is not exactly known what the Polish army was going to use these people for. Presumably, they were supposed to man underwater human torpedoes, aimed at the destruction of German warships. Most probably, the Polish army did not have the necessary equipment, but reportedly, in the summer of 1939, in Gdynia, 83 selected volunteers were shown a special short movie about torpedoes manned by humans. An officer of the Navy who was present stated that Poland had 16 such torpedoes. They were 8 meters long and weighed 420 kilograms. However, none of the volunteers ever saw these torpedoes. Some other volunteers were trained as glider pilots and parachute jumpers. Also, at that time, the Polish Navy created a Bureau of Living Torpedoes, which suggests that the idea was treated seriously. According to one of the volunteers, Marian Kaminski from Poznan, who saw the movie, Navy officers told him to return to Gdynia on October 12, 1939, for a 2-month training course. The course never started as Germany attacked Poland on September 1, 1939, but some of the volunteers had by then been drafted into another special ops unit for sabotage and operations behind enemy lines. It is now difficult to estimate how many people volunteered. Most probably there were as many as 4,700 men and some 150 women. The first people took their oaths on June 29, 1939. 3,000 names are documented as the Polish Navy issued special IDs for volunteers. It's a matter of debate among military historians whether there were any real plans for the combat usage of such suicidal units, or whether it was purely a matter of propaganda.